What can make the future of Sierra Leone bright? A number of factors, but I think most of all, we need to prioritize one, education, and two, we need to get rid of corruption. You know, no matter what we do, no matter how we design policies and programs, if our system continues to be tainted with filled and unbridled corruption, as it is the case currently, then I'm afraid we will only be reinventing the wheel time and again, which will take us nowhere. If we're serious, we have a political will, we're determined to change the system, and we have square pegs in square holes. We have a system, as I said, where we overhaul the whole system, we have the right people in the right places, and we prioritize education, because we're not going to change this country overnight. We have to look at how we're going to change the country in the coming years. And the only way we're going to change the country in the coming years is to prioritize education. And I'm not talking here about Elizabethan education, where people study only politics, English, and stuff like that. We have to come back to the education that will be practical, that will be necessary and required for the circumstances that we're having. We need technical vocational education. We need computer skills. We need development skills. We need education that will bring up, that will give us more engineers, more doctors, more contractors, more people, you know, in every area of our work. So by doing that, I think we'll be setting again very, very strong pillars for meaningful long-term development. And I think that is absolutely, absolutely important. If you can get that, and of course, why I always think education is important, because one thing that we also need in this country is a change in mentality. But I always also peg that to education, because the more people you have who are illiterate, who cannot think straight, then it's very difficult to manipulate them. It's very difficult for one politician to wake up in the morning and come and say, well, I'm going to give you a bag of fries, go and vote for me, and after that, that's it. You know, you do not care again what happens, and we continue to labor as we do. But if people are educated, then they can make informed and quality choices. Then they can engage their politicians. Then they will demand more from them. Then they will know their rights. Then they will know. So I think it has to be a whole question of education and a change in mentality, and as I said, abolishing corruption.
Why do you think everyone wants to go to America these days?
You know, I read someone very interesting, that every man is born free, and every man has a determination to be free, economically, socially, politically, morally. And whether you agree with me or not, America is the icon for such freedom in the world. The United States stands as the emblem for political freedom, for economic freedom, for economic enhancements. And people want to be affluent, people want to be rich, people want to make money, people want to realize their potentials. And they talk a lot about the American dream, where you wake up one morning and you believe in something and you pursue it and achieve it, because the opportunities exist. In the country where we are, as I said, people are desperate, people want to, but the system is not there, the opportunities are not there, and even the ones that are, the competition is so high, and even if you're that good as you think you are, it is not obvious that you'll be the chosen one, because as I said, the opportunities are so limited, and the system by which the people are appointed or are given these opportunities is so corrupt that, as I refer to, what I refer to as cronyism, you know, is what obtained. So people want to leave such environments and make something better for their lives, for their families, because there's a desire in every man, as I said, to be free, to be rich, at least, or to realize their potentials. So there's this buzz every Sierra Leone, and not even Sierra Leoneans. I mean, every African is dreaming to go to America to make themselves better, to make their families better, and to have an opportunity to realize their potentials in life.